one. The U.S. has 4 or 5, depending on how far you want to divide it between Alaska, Hawaii, and the East Coast. And so living in California, if you start your day at 7 a.m., it's 10 a.m. in New York. So the stock market's open, the banks are open, the business is running. And so what you find is that it's a very early morning culture. 5:30, 5 a.m. out on the road, there's a lot of traffic. And it's not traffic from people coming home from the bars the night before. It's actually traffic with people going to work in the morning. So I got here to India and I realized if I showed up in the office at 7:30 or 8 a.m., it was very lonely. Even the coffee boy hadn't arrived yet. So I started to adjust and I actually like it. It's quite nice. So, you know, I think it's a nice part of your culture. I actually am nocturnal, so I do much better after dark. And so it's been quite pleasant. But let me talk to you about innovation, a little bit about innovation very quickly. And because really where you're sitting and what you're doing and why you're here on a Saturday morning is because you have an innovation spirit in you. I know you do because of what you're doing. And if you're a student or a startup or even a member of the corporate world, obviously innovation is something that drives and drives and drives what we do. But you know, if you step back for a minute and think, what does it mean? Obviously it's a broad term, but in practice, everything has a definition, right? That's why we have Wikipedia, you can trust it. So everything has a definition, and the definition of innovation is either something new or significantly improved. And actually, I believe very strongly that new is pretty rare. It does happen, it does come along, it does require a different type of inventing. Significantly improved, or ultra significantly improved, is actually where you see massive success stories. Think about some of the largest companies in cap value in the world today that 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 30 years ago were startups. Were started by 2 people, 5 people, 10 people, 15 people. So even if you think about, you can rattle off your names. Google. Google certainly didn't invent the internet. They found a significantly better way to access it and then built that into a business. And then changed so many rules. They changed the method of advertising. They changed the licensing rules for software and created the terms of freeware. Found another way of monetization. They just thought of something significantly new. Apple certainly didn't invent the smartphone. They just found through the iOS, through the Touch UI, a significantly new and better way to use it. Uber, controversial as it is because of its management, Uber didn't invent the transportation or taxi system. In fact, didn't invent anywhere near it. They simply invented a better or new significant way to use it. And I could go on and on. Even ourselves as a company, Qualcomm, we are a startup. We're only a 30-year-old company. Even though we have, you know, tens of thousands of employees all over the world, we actually started as a company who believed that analog transmission, analog technology, was not the way the world would go, but rather digital. And then, of course, in the case of Qualcomm CDMA, digital, and the rest becomes history. And we'll talk a little bit more about that as we go out through the day. So when you stop and think about what you're doing in innovation, apply that. Sometimes you can get very, very hung up on how do I do something so archaically new, and yet applying this significantly different, you know, it simply applies across the board. Even Facebook didn't invent social networking, right? There was MySpace before that. There were a number of things before that. What they did was figure out how to integrate digital imaging, how to integrate cloud-based software, how to integrate artificial intelligence to make their product essentially simplistic and easier to use, and of course used by over 4 billion people across the planet who pay nothing to use it, okay, 100% free, which means nothing's free, so everything's being paid for just through a different methodology. Okay, so let me then talk a little bit about the business that we're in, because I can tell you, let me just put some anxiety to rest. If you're wondering what you're going to do with your life, now that you've, got on to the next step, don't, okay? I started in the wireless business, I hate to say this because I'm in a young room, in 1986, I took my first job in this industry. And so that means I spent my entire life my entire working life almost, as I say, I didn't become an adult until I was 30. So it took me a little bit of time in my 20s to understand adulthood. But I spent almost my entire life working in industry that was not invented when I graduated from university with my bachelor degree. So think about that. I had spent my whole life in an industry that was not even invented when I graduated from university. So there's a lot to come. There's a lot to come that you don't know, I don't know, we don't know, we don't see. And so I would say put your head down, go to work, and things will start to emerge around you, and you watch what happens. We are in an unbelievably fascinating time of technology. I talk about this because this is the business we're in at Qualcomm, right? We are the world's largest enabler of the wireless community, the connectivity community. But this has expanded so much beyond what it was when it started in terms of a cell phone. You see this term 9.7 billion mobile connections globally. There's only 7 billion people on the planet. Although I don't know about that. I mean, they tell me there's 1.3 billion people in this country, but honest to goodness, unless you've got a satellite with a heat map, I know there's more, okay? I'm convinced of it that there's more. So I'm positive, right? And but if you take a look at what we're talking about here on the mobile connections, really what has happened through connectivity is we have created the single largest platform for innovation in the world. And it's being used and utilized in many ways.
Very good morning to all of you. I don't know how many of you are traveling from outside Hyderabad, but for those of you who are coming into Hyderabad, welcome to this wonderful city of Hyderabad, the nerve center for startups at this point of time. You're actually sitting no more than about half a kilometer away from an institution called T-Hub, which got created in the last 3.5 years. And it's really bubbling with a tremendous amount of activity. We incubate about 300 startups at this point of time. So if some of you have not seen the place, and if you're here in Hyderabad, please make some time to go and visit the place. My apologies for I've been running a little late. It's very unusual for me to do that, but having put so many years of my own life, I still realize how some of these challenges that we have when you get entangled with a politician. I had a very senior political leader to come for breakfast this morning. He turned up just about an hour late, nothing more than that it was. But I didn't have much of complaints to do thereafter, but I had to entertain him and made sure yet another friend of ours. It's not that I wanted favors from the politician. I basically was trying to do a favor to one of the industry colleagues who's from NASSCOM, could get some money released for them. So that's the reason why I invited him for breakfast this morning. But sorry again for coming late, but let me do my bit in the next half an hour or so. It's about 10:30. So what I intend to do is tell you a story about building a successful, sustainable global company. I'll probably try my best to finish it off in about 20 minutes so that I leave about 10 minutes thereafter for you to do a Q&A with me. I guess I need to get this straightened out. Yes, it does. So just as a data point, what do my company do? My company is in the area of design, build, and operate and maintain products and systems. That's what the company does. We design products for aerospace companies like Boeing, so obviously, which means that we design airplanes. We design aircraft engines for companies like Pratt & Whitney, or we do transportation systems for Bombardier, which is a rail transportation company. Or we do many of things which are to do with networks, We work with utilities companies across the world designing the utility networks, which can be power, it can be telecom, it can be it can be cable, it can be sewer, and so it can be water, and so on and so forth. But as all of us understand, as new disruptions keep happening, as new technologies come by, data has become the king, and therefore we now have an overarching layer on top of all the services that we have, which is basically the digital layer that we call. And the digital layer helps us in terms of collecting a lot of information on what we are producing for our customers. Interestingly, about 3 years back, when originally the company was supposed to be a design engineering company, a young CEO took over the company, went and made a case to the board where he said our ability to design gives us the right to manufacture. So therefore, a small portion of what we actually design as engineering products to our customers around the world, we also manufacture them. And equally important was that some of the products that we do, if you recognize them, especially look at airplanes, aircrafts, and so on and so forth, these have a lifespan of about 30 to 35 years. That's how these engines last, or aircrafts last in the field. And typically when they come for repairs, you just don't repair by taking out a part and putting back a part. So there is a fairly large amount of what is called as aftermarket engineering services. So therefore, we design, we provide aftermarket, we build them, we provide the aftermarket engineering services, and an overarching layer on top of it is the digital data, and the data comes back to us to make sure we redesign these products back again more efficiently. That's what, in very short, what the company does. So where are we as a company today? Very simply, I started this company 26 years back in my modest home on my dining table with four engineers. That's where the story started. Fast forward 25 years, what we have is several service offerings that we have. We do product engineering, we do process engineering, we work with networks. We are also into geospatial as well as design-led manufacturing. Interestingly, we serve about seven different verticals right now. Aerospace is our largest vertical. But from no revenues, we now have $610 million of revenue, which in rupee terms, I believe, translates to a little over 4,000 crores of revenue. We have an EBITDA of $85 million. That's about, in addition to, in excess of about $500 million of EBITDA. Given the interest is fairly small, or it's not there, I think we do a little bit of arbitrage here there, but given that the company has about 1,200 or 1,500 crores of cash in the bank, the interest is not a big component, the depreciation takes off about 100 crores, so the net is about 400 crores this year. We employ about 14,500 people in the company, getting close to 15,000. The marketplaces are, we service North America, it's about 58% of our business, 29%, half of that comes from Europe, half of that 14% of it comes from Southeast Asia. If you add them up, and if it comes less than 100, the rest of it comes from India for us. So therefore, that's how our business profile is. So that's just about a data point of what we are. Let me move further down to tell you more about, in this last 25 or 26 years of my journey, what are the lessons that I learned? The first and the foremost lesson, which I think as entrepreneurs, all of us have to pay attention to, is the first is several things in my life have changed over the last 25 years, or since I started my career, or since I came into the, existence in this world. But one thing hasn't changed, and that which has not changed are my values. In my company, we keep saying values first. We play on this acronym called FIRST, which is basically FIRST, which stands for fairness, integrity, respect, sincerity, and transparency. We never made any compromises on these. And this is to us the foundation for the company. And that's what I urge every entrepreneur to think about. Please, please, all the time, pay attention to your values. I keep saying you lose your money, you'll get it back. You lose your health, it's very difficult to get it back. You lose your values, you'll never get them back. And on top of this, foundation, we think there are four pillars of strength which make companies successful. What are the four pillars of strength? Very obvious. The customer, the employee, whom we call them as the associates. And the third is your investor. But not many people recognize this as the fourth, and that is the society. Society also plays an extremely important role in your success. So therefore, I keep saying, even when you're small, when you're big, please don't cut corners. A startup company comes to us and says, you know, we made 15 lakhs profit for last financial year. You look at the books, it only shows 5 lakhs. So you ask him, where's that 10 lakhs gone? No, no, sir, that's still there, but I just didn't want to pay tax. I don't look at them any further, because that's in value erosion that happens. If you don't make, you might say, it's not small or big to me. Values remain the same, irrespective of who you are, what you are. So please, therefore, bear in mind that values are very important in terms of building your businesses, building your life itself, just businesses alone. And certainly, I think it is it's your responsibility to pay back to the society. I did engineering. I did mechanical engineering. That's by training, I'm a mechanical engineer. I'm sure, except for a few people in the front row, most of you and the rest of the crowd here would not have been even born when I did my engineering. That was in 1971. That's when I graduated. But I paid 250 rupees for every year for my engineering education. Tell me how I could have been ever educated with 250 rupees. So obviously, it was not my money which educated me. It's a society which subsidized me to be what I am today. So therefore, it is a responsibility of every one of you to make sure you pay attention to the society. So my first lesson was values first, and then you have to be equitable to all the stakeholders. See, if you look at these four stakeholders, they are at cross purposes of each other from time to time. Employee wants the best salary. My investor wants the best return on the investment they make. My customer wants the lowest price. Your ability to handle all of them is the one which makes you successful. And the only way that you can handle all of them is be equitable to every one of the stakeholders. My lesson number two, I'm sorry, I didn't do the lesson number one itself. That's the, okay. My lesson number two is all about your ability to identify a problem, solve a problem, and continuously differentiate yourself from others. That's the key driver for you to be building sustainable companies. It cannot be that you can think about a problem in your glass cubicle and think about a solution further down and then say, I'm going to conquer the world. It doesn't happen that way. Our first problem was that we saw a real problem. There was a need for low-cost engineering services from India. And what did we do? We found a solution to it. That was a global delivery model. And that solution helped us in making sure we could sustain scale our business and sustain our business. Certainly, the second thing that I talk about is that number of people who are entrepreneurs think that, you know, profit is a bad word. Profit is not a bad word. Actually, you'd be very surprised, I'll tell you, that even customers love this world called profitable companies. Customers want you to be profitable. That's when truly they are your customers. And actually, we go one more step above that, and then say, number of our customers don't even call us as suppliers. They call us as partners. That's when you're doing value creation to them. Because the customer, when he starts calling you a partner and not a supplier, he truly values you. He truly sees that there's a value creation that you are doing. So therefore, your focus has to be in terms of making sure you create value. And in the process of creating value for your customer, you're also profitable. So when you think about a business, please think about profitable businesses. Businesses have to be profitable. They have to be sustainable. They have to be de-risked, and they have to be predictable. You do a business which you don't know what's going to happen next month, then it's not the right business to be in. That is what we built our company on. business model was profitable, predictable, de-risked business. So the result is that if you are looking at a business, the second lesson that I learned is that look at a business which is to identify a problem and solve it. And a third thing is that there is nothing called stationary situation for you in business. It's constantly changing. And so, you know, if you start even running at a pace which is just like any others, then it's like running on the treadmill. You're stationary right there. You've got to be ahead of many others. So the only way that you could be ahead of many others is constantly you innovate yourself. When we found hurdles in the initial stages of our business, we found an adjacency called GIS, Geographic Information Systems. And what is GIS? It's all about, you know, information on the land, about the land, in, on top of the land, and so on and so forth. That today, 25 years back, it's a hot product because it's all location-based services. Everybody wants to know where you are, where the assets are, where communications are going on at this point of time. So then, you know, about 8 years later, we got a break in terms of engineering. That was another breakthrough, but engineering started off as a service. We moved up the value chain from a service to a subsystem design to a solution design. Thereafter, we now have an ability to say that we design, but we manufacture, we maintain, and we have data which helps us in terms of providing a better design to the same customer. That's the value creation. Nobody else can do that. Nobody else currently cannot do that. We'll do something else as we move forward. So therefore, you've got to, if you want to start up a business, a part of my first, second lesson is that you need to continuously differentiate yourself. And how do we do that? Is differentiation comes through innovation. A company like us, which primarily people believe is a services company, we have our own innovation labs. We are now thinking ahead of our customers, thinking ahead of customers in terms of providing them solutions. So therefore, if you look at the innovation hub that we have a legal lab, a rail signaling lab, an IoT lab, and so many more. Last weekend, we did a drone hackathon in our company. 1,400 applications came in. We curated, and finally had seven of them. And amazing were the applications we saw on drones. And I feel very delighted because an all-women team with three young ladies won the first prize of 3 lakhs. And what was the application? It's about women's safety using drones. A small app they built. And what you do on the app is that, you know, if you're in distress, a woman or a man for that matter, press the button on your smartphone. And drones are parked in police stations. They come far ahead of the cop. They not only come far ahead of the cop, they're in a position to save pictures, they also are in a position to live stream the data. And finally, they actually make a lot of noise. And I'm sure all of us recognize a criminal is very worried when he's been seen by others. So the fact that there are pictures being taken almost, you know, in a lapse of 3 minutes to 4 minutes makes the crime come down quite dramatically. And that is coming out of the lab that we have on drones at this point of time and then the hackathon that we did. That's our innovation lab. It's called Transactional MFA. Transactional Market Feedback Analysis. What's transactional? Every time that I submit a piece of work to my customer, the customer evaluates my work, gives me feedback. That's called transactional MFA. And this is typically between an engineer to engineer. Engineer tells you how good or how bad is a piece of work is. Our belief is that particular piece of feedback that comes to us has certain amount of bias. Because, you know, engineers believe, well, my manager and his manager are great boozy pals. So the result is that I don't probably, even if I wrote something wrong, my manager will come and scream at me as opposed to take some corrective action. So having understood that this possibly could have certain amount of bias, we go to the next level, which is called the periodic MFA. Every 3 months, there is a transaction between the manager to manager. We want every manager who is a customer of ours to give us a feedback every 3 months to say how we are performing. And the finale comes that every year we have a third-party MFA, the third part of it. We use people like the Gallup to do a survey of all our customers. We currently have, I believe, about 300 active customers in our list. These 300 active customers convert to about 1,400 or 1,800 touch points. But what we do, 52, okay, I'm there. What we do is making sure that customers give us a feedback. Customers actually rate us through the third party, and we learn from this feedback or exactly how we're performing. So actually, if you look at the third party MFA feedback that comes to us, what we do thereafter, it takes us almost 3 months to analyze the data, 3 months thereafter to assimilate it and say what the plan of action that we need to do, and then start implementing them for 3 more months before we start saying the next round has to come by and we start putting questions together. And one of the things that has constantly come to us is our ability to improve innovation. The customers say that, you know, look, you guys have to do much better innovation than what we are. We do a lot of effort in this direction. We now have something called the ideas management tool. It was actually an ideas management tree at one point of time, which got converted into an idea management tool when it became almost impossible to manage it. And we also have a new technology accelerator program. So initiatives of this nature are the ones which are making sure that our customer satisfaction is at its best. You point out innovation is not right. Today, the effort for the last 24 months is an enormous amount of effort on innovation. And at the end of it, you get rewards and rewards. A company like Boeing recognizes for the fourth year now, I believe. We just got the information last few days where we are the supplier of the year for them. Thank you. My lesson number 5, I need to speed up, is my people. People make a difference, and my belief in life is wealth generators are the people of the company, so you need to share the wealth with them. 5% of our market cap, 5% of our equity in the company have been doled out as associate stock options. And to give you a flavor, that what that money would mean, the company has a 7,500 crore market cap. So what we gave up to the employees at this point of time is between 300 to 400 crores. And the employees do tell us all about how they build their homes, how their children got married or children got educated. There can't be a better satisfaction than that. But more importantly, what you need to do is make sure you continuously engage them. But at times it could be potentially getting into a point of ridicule. To on the lighter vein like to share with you, given that I have a time constraint too, but I'll still do that, is that one day my HR boss came and told me that we need to have cricket being played. There's a fairly nice 1.5 acres of piece of land just on this particular street. Further down, we have a very large campus. He said, "Let Mohan, you know, we need to get this cricket going. People will be very enthused. You know, engagement levels will go up." I said, "Perfectly fine." So he said, "No, Mohan," I said, "how about time?" He said, 11 people on each side. That's all cricket team is about. So I said, yes, I understand 11 people on each time. So it says 22 people time off from 4 o'clock in the evening till 6:30, 2 hours they'll play before the sunset on. I went one day at about 4:30 in the to the campus. And what did I find? Not only the 22 people, but probably another 4,000 people watching the game. So those are the things that you have to be careful about when you say employee engagement. But this is what we do with learning and engagement, leadership development, and we also have a global careers for people. Now we have a diversity and inclusion being led by a woman leader in the company. Katie Cook runs that. We, at this point of time, are very disappointed with what we do. While at the entry level, we are in a position to get about 50% of women, but by the time the company's average now is only at about 29%, I believe. We lose them quite quickly. We're trying to find ways and means by which we can retain them. I've got 3 more to go. Three lessons is that, you know, one of the lessons I have for all you as entrepreneurs, don't look for money when you are in desperate need of it. Please raise money when you don't need it. Not that you want to flounder it and flourish it and buy a Mercedes-Benz car, but make sure that you go to the people at the right time. Because what happens is, if you are really not doing well and tell all the stories, people won't give you money. What I did over a period of time is made sure that I raised money. Thrice is when we did an IPO in 1997. There was a private placement with Pratt & Whitney in 2002, and also yet another private placement with General Atlantic Partners in 2007. Just to give you a reflection how much I respect my shareholder, a lakh of rupees invested in 1997 in our public issue. 20 years later, people are still invested in our company, turned out to be 297 lakhs. So therefore, when you have the trust built in, people will give you money. So please do not think about shortcuts in terms of making money. In the city of Hyderabad especially, we have a very poor reputation. Entrepreneurs make money very quickly, not for the company, but for themselves. But therefore, very unashamedly, I'm going to say this, that please don't look at those shortcuts. Investors will reward you with good multiples if they can trust you. My lesson number 7 is how do you build globalized companies? If you want to have a globalized company, it requires global footprint. Some of you who are very early stage entrepreneurs come to me and tell me, Mr. Reddy, I'm selling into Dubai, I'm going to Europe, and then after US. Please don't do this. It's too early for you to do it. You have to get the level of mass and maturity before you start getting into global markets. If you truly want to be a global player, you got to make sure you have a global footprint. You got to have a physical location. Only then you get the best out of them. So we now have offices in many other locations around the world. My last favorite, of course, is we now have an office in Prague, the Czech Republic, which has got about 400 of our engineers who are taking care of our European onshore business. The other thing is that if you want to be truly a global company, you need to have a global mindset. A global mindset which has a global workforce and a global leadership. I have 15 of my level 1 leaders, starting off with CEO. He is a level 0 leader. He runs the business now. And if you look at this 15 of them, 5 of them are foreign individuals. So therefore, if you want to truly build a global company, you need to have a global workforce. And to support that thing, I keep saying in the lighter vein, and I can say it loudly, Trump, no Trump, it doesn't bother us. Trump talks about visa regulations, visa restrictions, etc. We built a company in such a way, 80% of our employees in United States, which is not a small number, as we speak, I believe we have 1,700 of them, are local US citizens. So therefore, if you truly want to build a global company, you need to have a global workforce, a global footprint, and making sure that you have global leadership. And finally, my lesson number 9, before I get booted out from here, is to say that you need to have a good corporate governance. People value your governance. You will have challenges. You don't have money at that point of time. But then, you got to face them. Look at the first one. You need to identify a real problem. So that doesn't require money. Then come out with a real solution that doesn't require money. Your ability to scale the business doesn't require money. So you would have some of them which don't require money. You can do them. The problems are there. In the first 7 years of my business, my two largest customers went bankrupt. I have to cover them. There are sleepless nights that you would go through. I would be very open and transparent, and I'll tell you that there was an IP violation that one of my software engineers did in one customer case, and it became a legal issue. Sleepless nights. This is all the first 5 years of existence. So how do you do that? It's the courage which says, look, I'll tell you one thing. If you say that, look, there's a problem, I'm very dejected, this is no more, I'm going to stop it, you're a loser, period. But wake up in the morning and say, no, I can't be a loser, I'll fight it back again. That's how the energy comes back to you. So please don't give up. Please, please don't give up. There are bad days and good days. You're on cloud 9. You're absolutely, I'm in the dumps. I'm in the same. I'll come back to work next morning and say, there is something unfulfilled dream of mine. I had a big dream. One of the things I keep telling people that is when this wisdom dawned on me, is that I started thinking about, if I disappear from this world, what will be written on my tombstone? They would say, 1950 born, whenever I disappear, that was the date, that was all it is, or put my full name, Bodhanapu Venkat Rama Mohan Reddy, in all bold letters. That's not what I wanted. That's what an entrepreneur should think about. We should be known something. We should definitely leave something behind in this world. If you think about that, then you'll say, no, there's nothing called low, there's nothing called challenge for me. I'll come back and do something better and better. Become more successful entrepreneurs than I am. I'll be very honest to say this last comment of mine. If you take an IQ test between all of us in this room, I would assure you one thing, that I will be in the bottom quartile of this group of people. So you are much more smarter than I am. I made up my life by making sure that I worked hard, I never gave up in my life, etc. All those you can also do. But you have advantage compared to me, you have a better IQ than I do. You're much more smarter than I am. So therefore, you have much better chance not only to become successful, but more successful than I am. I'll wish you all the best. Thank you.
My name is Avinash Manda. I am an alumni of IIT Kanpur. So we are organizing the Startup Masterclass in Hyderabad. It's our 10th edition. So we have 9 editions already happened. We call it SMC, Startup Masterclass. It has happened in Kanpur, Bangalore before. It's happening for the first time in Hyderabad. For this event, we have been organizing since 3 months. So we reached out to all the startups, speakers, investors, incubators, accelerators, and co-working spaces in Hyderabad. And we have a registrations of around 500 and 30 plus speakers and around 300 startups. So the main event is where the speakers will be talking to all the startups. We have keynote and few sessions, and we have Qualcomm, who is a lead sponsor. They have had Qualcomm Design India Challenge, which is QDIC. It's their 3rd edition. They'll be organizing it today. Apart from that, we have the main 2 events called SMC Select and one-on-one mentoring session. I'm leading SMC Select and one-on-one. So SMC Select is a pitching event where we had around a lot of startups applied for that with their presentation decks. So we had a panel of judges who have shortlisted the top 10, and the top 10 startups will be pitching today from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. in front of all the leading judges, and top 3 startups will be awarded prizes. And our IITK ecosystem will be helping them accelerate the startup. So every startup masterclass, we have SMC Select, and all the top 3 winners will be given chance to interact with the IITK ecosystem. And other main USP of SMC is one-on-one mentoring session, which is the main unique event for SMC, where all the startups will be registering for one-on-one session, and each startup will be given around 10 to 15 minutes time to interact with a mentor or an investor. So we have around 100 registrations. So we will be facilitating 100 startups to interact with mentors or the investors 10 to 15 minutes in a conference room discussion. We can say it's an informal pitch or a mentoring session. So that's the unique event of SMC. We have one-on-one and SMC Select. We are coordinating that. That one-on-one mentoring will be happening in parallel to the main event. And currently we are having one-on-one. We have a lot of registrations happening. A lot of mentors and investors are currently here, and we are having startups interact with them. And SMC Select will be in the afternoon. That's pretty much our event. And we have a lot of startups, and this event is basically helping a lot of startups to get started and accelerate. And it's helping them to network and interact with the IITK ecosystem and Pan IIT Alumni Association. Even though the event is being organized with IIT Kanpur alumni, we have interaction with ISB, IIT Hyderabad, IIT Kharagpur, and IIT Madras alumni also helping out in the outreach and the organizing of the event. This event is the first time in Hyderabad. and we are looking forward to this great event. And we, as of now, I feel the event has been organized and it went very well, and it would be a great success even at the end of the day. The main, coming to the volunteers and organizers, it's basically a voluntary event. It's a non-profit. Everyone is just here voluntarily to help the startups to interact and help them accelerate in their network. The main challenge we had is in Hyderabad is compared to Bangalore, startup-wise, and the list of startups over here are little less, but our outreach was incredible and we were able to reach to many startups. And we had around 100 registrations for one-on-one, and SMC Select, we had many startups registered. So basically, the way we interacted with the startups is we reached out to all the co-working spaces. We had around 30 co-working spaces, 30 accelerators in Hyderabad. So we reached out to them and we shared our invite and email invite and our posters with them, and they forwarded it in their network. And that's how we did our outreach, and we had a good turnout here, and it will help all the Hyderabad-based startups. The main outreach, how we did it is we had it through LinkedIn, and we have multiple startup groups in Facebook as well. So we interacted with the startups on Facebook, and we have invited over them to the event. And I think being the first event in Hyderabad, it's a grand success, and looking forward to more editions in Hyderabad coming forward years.
మన దేశంలో ఉండి మనకి ముఖ్యమైనటువంటి ఛాలెంజ్ ఏంటి అంటే ఎక్కువ జాబ్స్ క్రియేట్ చేయాలి మనం. ఆ జాబ్స్ క్రియేట్ చేయడానికి ఒక విధానం ఏంటంటే చాలా ఎంటర్ప్రినర్స్ని ప్రమోట్ చేసి వాళ్ళు కంపెనీస్ స్థాపిస్తే చాలా వరకు మన పిల్లలకి ఉద్యోగాలు వస్తాయన్నమాట. అది ఆబ్జెక్టివ్గా పెట్టుకొని నేను మా ఐఐటి కాన్పూర్ అలమ్ని అసోసియేషన్ వాళ్ళు స్టార్టప్ మాస్టర్ క్లాస్ని రన్ చేస్తారన్నమాట. ఈ స్టార్టప్ మాస్టర్ క్లాస్లో మేము చేసేది ఏంటంటే ఈ ఎంటర్ప్రినర్స్ని ఎంకరేజ్ చేయటం అనమాట. చాలామందికి మన కథేంటి, మనం ఇంతవరకు సక్సెస్ఫుల్ అయ్యామంటే ఏమేమి చేసాము, ఇవన్నీ షేర్ చేయటం వల్ల రెండు మూడు సంగతులు జరుగుతాయన్నమాట. ఒకటి నాలెడ్జ్ షేరింగ్, మనకు ఉన్నటువంటి నాలెడ్జ్ వాళ్ళతో షేర్ చేయగలగటం. రెండోదేమో వాళ్ళకు బాగా మోటివేషన్ అనమాట, ఇలా పైకి వచ్చారు మనం కూడా పైకి రావచ్చు అనేటటువంటి ఆలోచన వాళ్ళకు వస్తుంది. మూడోదండి, అన్నిటికన్నా ముఖ్యమైనది నెట్వర్కింగ్ జరుగుతుందన్నమాట. అంటే కొంతమంది పిల్లలకి కొన్ని క్వశ్చన్స్ ఉంటాయి, వాళ్ళు ఎవరిని అడగలేరు, కానీ వాళ్ళ తెలిసినటువంటి పియర్స్ని అడగటంతో, వాళ్ళు తెలిసిన అదే ఏజ్ గ్రూప్లో కలిసిన వాళ్ళతో కలవటంతో జరిగేది ఏంటి అంటే తప్పకుండా వాళ్ళ క్వశ్చన్ కూడా ఆన్సర్ అవుతాయి అన్నమాట. ఈ మూడు ఆబ్జెక్టివ్స్, నాలెడ్జ్ షేరింగ్ ఒకటి, రెండోదేమో ఎంకరేజ్మెంటు, మూడోదేమో పియర్ టు పియర్ లెర్నింగ్, వాళ్ళు నెట్వర్కింగ్ చేసుకోగలుగుతారని చెప్పి ఐఐటి కాన్పూర్ అలమ్ని అసోసియేషన్ వాళ్ళు ఈ ఈవెంట్ని స్టార్ట్ చేశారు. దీన్ని స్టార్టప్ మాస్టర్ క్లాస్ అంటారు. దీన్నండి మనం వేరే వేరే సిటీస్లో రన్ చేస్తూ ఉన్నారు. ఐఐటి కాన్పూర్ అలుమ్ని అయినా కూడా కాన్పూర్లో ఒక రెండు వారాల క్రితం చేసాము, నేను కూడా వెళ్ళాను పర్సనల్గా. ఈరోజు హైదరాబాద్లో చేస్తున్నాము, మంచిగా స్పందన జరిగిందండి. ఒక 300-400 మంది స్టార్టప్ ఎంటర్ప్రినర్స్ వచ్చారు, మంచి స్పీకర్స్ కూడా వచ్చారు ఈరోజు. వీళ్ళందరితో ఈరోజు ఇట్స్ డే ప్రోగ్రామ్ అనమాట. సాయంకాలంకి చాలామంది వాళ్ళ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ జరగటం, లంచ్లో వీళ్ళందరూ మీట్ అవ్వటం, నెట్వర్క్ చేసుకోవడం జరుగుతుందండి. ఇండియాలో స్టార్టప్ కంపెనీ సిచ్యువేషన్ చాలా ఎన్కరేజింగ్గా ఉందండి. రెండు మూడు విషయాలు ఉందన్నమాట. ఒకటి ఏంటంటే మనకు స్టార్టప్ అనేటటువంటిది ఇమినెంట్ నీడ్ అనమాట, అవసరం మనకి ఈ రోజుల్లో. మన పిల్లలకి ఉద్యోగాలు కావాలి. చాలా స్టడీస్ ఉన్నాయండి ప్రపంచంలో, పెద్ద కంపెనీస్ ఎక్కువ ఉద్యోగాలు క్రియేట్ చేయవు, చిన్న చిన్న కంపెనీనే ఎక్కువ ఉద్యోగాలు క్రియేట్ చేస్తాయి అన్నమాట. అందుకోసం మన చిన్న కంపెనీలు అంటే స్టార్టప్ని బాగా ఎంకరేజ్ చేయాలి, అదొక రీజన్ అనమాట. రెండేటటువంటిదండి, మీరు టెక్నాలజీని చూస్తే ప్రపంచంలో ఎప్పుడూ టెక్నాలజీ ఇంత యాక్సలరేషన్లో లేదు, ఇంత గొప్పగా రోజు రోజు మారటం రావట్లేదు అనమాట. ఈ రోజు టెక్నాలజీ మారటంతో కొత్త ఆపర్చునిటీస్ వస్తాయి మనకి. ఈ ఆపర్చునిటీస్ని ఎంటర్ప్రినర్స్ని దాన్ని కన్వర్ట్ చేసుకుని ఒక ఎంటర్ప్రైజ్గా తయారు చేస్తారనమాట. ఈ రెండు కారణాలుగా, ఎందుకంటే ఒకటి తర్వాత మూడో కారణం చెప్తాను. మూడో కారణం ఏంటంటే మన గవర్నమెంట్ కూడా చాలా ప్రోత్సాహం ఇస్తున్నారండి ఎంటర్ప్రినర్స్కి. ఈ స్టార్టప్ ఈకోసిస్టమ్ క్రియేట్ చేస్తున్నారు మన సెంట్రల్ గవర్నమెంట్ అయితేనేమి, స్టేట్ గవర్నమెంట్ అయితేనేమి. స్టేట్ గవర్నమెంట్లో మనం టీ హబ్ అంటూ ఒకటి క్రియేట్ చేసాము. ఆ టీ హబ్ ద్వారా ఏం జరుగుతుందంటే కంప్లీట్ ఈకోసిస్టమ్ క్రియేట్ చేసాము. ఈకోసిస్టమ్ ఏంటి, ఆ కోవర్కింగ్ స్పేస్ అయితేనేమి, మెంటర్షిప్ అయితేనేమి, వాళ్ళకి ఫండింగ్ జరగాలంటే అయితేనేమి, వాళ్ళ టెక్నికల్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ సాల్వ్ చేయడానికి కొంత ఆర్ఎండ్ వర్క్ వాళ్ళతో కలిసి పనిచేయటం ఏంటి. సో ఈ దాని మూలంగా ఎంటర్ప్రినర్షిప్ బాగా పైకి వస్తుంది అన్నమాట. అలాగే గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా కూడా ఈజ్ ఆఫ్ డూయింగ్ బిజినెస్ మీద చాలా ఫోకస్ చేస్తున్నారు. ఇంత కష్టాలు ఉండకూడదు, ఇంత టైం అనవసరంగా వృధాగా స్పెండ్ చేయకూడదు, వీటన్నిటి మూలంగా అండి మన స్టార్టప్ ఈకో సిస్టమ్ బాగా వృద్ధిలోకి వస్తూ ఉంది. టైం అనేటటువంటిది అండి, ప్రతి టైం పీరియడ్లో కష్టాలంటూ ఉంటాయి ఒక ఎంటర్ప్రైజ్ స్టార్ట్ చేయడానికి. ఒక విధంగా మీరు అనుకోవచ్చు ఆ రోజుల్లో, అంటే నేను స్టార్టప్ చేసి 25 ఏళ్ళైంది 26 ఏళ్ళైంది ప్రస్తుతానికి, ఆ రోజుల్లో ఇంత కాంపిటీషన్ ఉండేదా, లేకపోవచ్చు, లేకపోతే కొంత టైం ఉండేదా మీకు, ఉండొచ్చు. కానీ ఒకటండి, ఆ రోజుల్లో రెగ్యులేషన్స్ చాలా కష్టంగా ఉండేవన్నమాట. ఒక కంప్యూటర్ ఇంపోర్ట్ చేయాలంటే ఒక 3 నెలలు పట్టేది, ఒక సాఫ్ట్వేర్ రావాలంటే 6 నెలలు పట్టేది. అటువంటి కష్టాలన్నీ ఉదగమించాం కదా, ఎటువంటి పరిస్థితి. అందుకోసం మీరు టైం పీరియడ్స్తో తీసుకుంటే ప్రతి టైం పీరియడ్స్తో వాటికి అసోసియేటెడ్ ఛాలెంజెస్ ఉంటాయి, ఆ ఛాలెంజెస్ మారుతూ ఉంటాయన్నమాట. సో దాంతో ఒకప్పుడు బాగుండేది, ఒకప్పుడు వేరేగా ఉంది లేదు. నా ప్రకారం అండి ఇంత మంచి పరిస్థితి ఎప్పుడు ఉండేది కాదు ఇటువంటి, ఎందుకంటే టెక్నాలజీ మారిపోతూ ఉంది, టెక్నాలజీతో పాటు ఛాలెంజెస్ వస్తున్నాయి, ఛాలెంజెస్తో పాటు ఆపర్చునిటీస్ వస్తాయి, ఆపర్చునిటీస్ కన్వర్ట్ చేస్తే చాలా ఎంటర్ప్రైజెస్ వస్తాయి మనకి. నేను పర్సనల్గా అయితే ఇనిషియేటివ్ తీసుకుంటానండి, నాకు ఫ్యామిలీ ఆఫీస్ అంటూ ఉంది, మా ఫ్యామిలీ ఆఫీస్ నుంచి ఇన్వెస్ట్ చేస్తున్నాము. కానీ నేను ఇంకో విషయం చెప్పడానికి ఏంటంటే, ఫండ్స్ మాత్రం ఛాలెంజ్ కానే కాదండి, మీరు చెప్పింది అంత కరెక్ట్ కాదు. ఎందుకంటే మంచి ఐడియా ఉంటే కావాల్సినంత ఫండ్స్ ఉన్నాయండి దేశంలో. సో మీ నేను పిల్లలకు చెప్పేది ఏంటంటే, ఐడియా మీద కాన్సన్ట్రేట్ చేయండి, ఐడియాకి ఒక సొల్యూషన్ రావాలి. ముఖ్యంగా చెప్పేది ఏంటంటే, ఈ ఐడియాస్ కూడా అండి మీరు ఒక రూమ్లో కూర్చొని ఆలోచించుకొని ఓ ఇది ఒక పెద్ద ప్రాబ్లం అని సాల్వ్ చేద్దాం అనుకోకూడదు. మీరు వెళ్ళి రియల్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ చూడండి, ఫీల్డ్లో ఏం ప్రాబ్లం ఉన్నాయి, దానికి నేను యునిక్గా ఎలా సొల్యూషన్ కనిపెడతాను, ఆ సొల్యూషన్ కనిపెట్టిన తర్వాత నేను ఎలా స్కేల్ చేయగలను దీన్ని, అది ఒకరికి కాదు రెండు కాదు కాదు ప్రపంచమే జయించాలి మనం. అటువంటి ఆలోచన నుండి అటువంటి ప్రాజెక్ట్ ప్లాన్ మీరు తీసుకొస్తే డబ్బుకు అసలు ఏమాత్రం సమస్య లేదండి. నాలాంటి వాళ్ళు కాదు, ఎంతోమంది ఉన్నారు ఇవ్వటానికి. అదే కాదు స్టార్టప్ ఈకోసిస్టమ్ ఏ సిరీస్ అంటారు, బి సిరీస్ అంటారు, డబ్బు చాలా ఉందండి, అది కష్టమే కాదు. కాకపోతే చాలామంది కంప్లైంట్ చేస్తారు ఏంటంటే, ఆ డబ్బు లేదండి, నాకు డబ్బు ఎవరు ఇవ్వటం లేదని చెప్పి. డబ్బు ఇవ్వటం కాదు, మీ ఐడియా సరిగ్గా లేదు. నేను ఇప్పుడు అందరికీ అదే చెప్తాను అన్నమాట, ఐడియా చక్కగా ఉంటే తప్పకుండా డబ్బు ఆటోమేటిక్గా వస్తుంది. నేను పిల్లలకి ఇచ్చే అడ్వైజ్ ఒకటండి, ముఖ్యమైన అడ్వైజ్ ఏంటంటే, మన లైఫ్లో ఎన్నో చేంజ్ అవుతాయి కానీ మన వాల్యూస్ చేంజ్ అవ్వకూడదు. మన సంస్కృతి ఏంటి, మనం అందరికీ ఫేర్గా ఉండాలి, మనం అందరితో పాటు ఇంటెగ్రిటీ మెయింటైన్ చేయాలి. సో తప్పకుండా ఎంటర్ప్రినర్స్ అందరూ సిన్సియారిటీతో ఇంటెగ్రిటీతో పనిచేస్తే తప్పకుండా పైకి వస్తారు. అది ఫస్ట్ సజెషన్ అండి, అది నాకు దాన్ని నేను ఫౌండేషన్ అంటాను అన్నమాట. ఆ తర్వాత మనం మంచి ప్రాబ్లం గురించి చూడండి, ఊరికి మీరు ఒక సమస్యని మీ అంతా మీరు ఆలోచించుకొని ఈ సమస్య ఉంది అని అనుకోకండి, పోయి టెస్ట్ చేయండి, ఫీల్డ్ టెస్ట్ చేయండి, దాని సొల్యూషన్ కనిపెట్టండి, ఒక టీం తయారు చేయండి, ఆ టీంని స్కేల్ చేయండి, అప్పుడే తప్పకుండా సక్సెస్ఫుల్ అవుతారు. కస్టమర్ ఒకటి చాలా ముఖ్యమండి. కస్టమర్ అనేటువంటి మనకు, నేను మా సంస్థలో చేరేటటువంటి పిల్లల్ని అడుగుతా అనమాట, మీ శాలరీ ఎవరు ఇస్తారని. చాలామంది చెప్తారు కంపెనీ ఇస్తున్నారు కదా అని చెప్పి, ఆ న్యాచురల్ ఇన్స్టింక్ట్ అనమాట, కంపెనీ ఇస్తారు కదా శాలరీ ఇంకెవరు ఇస్తారని. కంపెనీ ఇవ్వరండి, కస్టమర్స్ ఇస్తారు శాలరీ. కస్టమర్ ఇచ్చే చెక్ నా బ్యాంక్లో పడితే నేను దాన్ని తీసి మీకు శాలరీగా ఇస్తానమాట. అందుకోసం మనం ఈ ఎంటర్ప్రినర్స్ చెప్పేది ఏంటంటే, కస్టమర్ ఇస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్, యువర్ ఎంప్లాయీస్ ఆర్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఇవన్నీ సరిగ్గా చూసుకోండి. మీరు అంటాం ఓ చాలా చెప్తున్నారు మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారు చాలా ఉన్నాయి విషయాలని, కాదండి చాలా, ఇవన్నీ చాలా సింపుల్ థింగ్స్ అనమాట. ఇవన్నీ ఒక పేజ్లో రాసుకోవచ్చు మీరు, ఆ పేజ్లో రాసుకొని అన్నిటికీ టిక్ మార్కింగ్ పెట్టి దాని మీద ఒకరోజు కృషి కాదు, ఇది కంటిన్యూస్ ప్రాసెస్ అనమాట. ఒకరోజు నేను జయించేస్తా అంటే విజయం కాదు, ఈ కంపెనీ పెట్టుకున్న తర్వాత రోజు కష్టపడాలి. మరి రోజు కష్టపడటం కాదు, నేను కష్టపడటం నేను ఎంజాయ్ చేస్తాను. యూ హ్యావ్ ఎన్ ఎంజాయబుల్ జర్నీ వెన్ యూ స్టార్ట్ సేయింగ్ దట్ యు నో దిస్ ఇస్ మై కంపెనీ, ఐఎమ్ క్రియేటింగ్ ఎ వాల్యూ ఫర్ ది సొసైటీ.
దిస్ ఈస్ ఎన్ ఎక్సలెంట్ ఈవెంట్ విచ్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ ఆర్గనైజ్డ్ బై ద ఐఐటి కాన్పూర్ అలుమ్ని అసోసియేషన్ అండ్ ఐఎమ్ రియలీ వెరీ హ్యాపీ టు పార్టిసిపేట్ ఇన్ దిస్. బీయింగ్ ఎన్ అలుమ్ని ఆల్సో ఫ్రమ్ ద ఐఐటి కాన్పూర్ I really feel very happy about it. The event is great and looking at the participation and the enthusiasm of the participants, it's very encouraging. In our country we need lot of startups in the areas of social sector and other areas as well, besides the startups which are technology driven. Rather, we must have startups which are technology driven as well as catering to the social sectors, to the public at large, because the Indian economy is growing at a faster rate and in times to come the economic activity in India is going to grow, and where the startups can take advantage of this situation, they can grow, prosper and really serve to the country as well. That is where the role of these kind of events becomes very, very important, and I'm very hopeful that the deliberations, the discussions and the exposures which the startup people, the startup companies get here from the experience of others will certainly help them. One piece of advice which I would like to tell them is that regarding the starting a company, then have patience with it and then take a path which they feel is good for the country and the society. Because of the growth of the country and the economy at which is growing at a very fast pace, I'm very sure that each and every startup has tremendous potential. I would like to suggest and advise the people that whatever it happens, if they do a good job, if they do it sincerely, diligently and with the hard work, they are bound to succeed, because there is always a potential, there is a scope and there is a place in this country. Niti Aayog has a lot of activities regarding encouraging startups. We have Atal Innovation Mission. We have a lot of policies where we help startups. We had an interaction of the Prime Minister, Honorable Shri Modi ji, also with the startups conference, where we organized an event in the month of September. That was the Champions of Change, where we had all the startup and the bigger startups interacting with the Prime Minister itself. So at that level, we are organizing a lot of activities, events for the encouraging startups. We also can have a memorandum of understanding or some kind of understanding with the organizers of these kind of events like IIT Kanpur Alumni Association or the alumni associations of other institutions, to take it further, to reach out to the smaller places, to reach out each and everybody, to reach out each and every youth of India who want to contribute towards the economic activity of the country. Thank you.
నా పేరు రాకేష్ మున్ననూరు అండ్ ఐ రన్ ఏ కంపెనీ కాల్డ్ విసిల్ డ్రైవ్. సో విసిల్ డ్రైవ్లో మేము డ్రైవర్ ఆన్ డిమాండ్ అండ్ ఎంప్లాయీ ట్రాన్స్పోర్టేషన్ సొల్యూషన్ ప్రొవైడ్ చేస్తాం. డ్రైవర్ ఆన్ డిమాండ్ అంటే ఏంటంటే, ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ మీకు కార్ ఉంది అండ్ యూ నీడ్ ఎ డ్రైవర్ ఫర్ యువర్ కార్ ఫర్ ఎ కపుల్ ఆఫ్ అవర్స్ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ డే, మేము ట్రైన్ వెరిఫైడ్ డ్రైవర్స్ని మా యాప్లో కానీ మా నెంబర్కి కానీ కాల్ చేస్తే, మా నెంబర్ ఇస్ 8499-04-0404, ఆ నెంబర్కి కాల్ చేస్తే యూ గెట్ ఎ ట్రైన్ డ్రైవర్ ఎట్ యువర్ హోమ్, సో దట్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ ఆర్ యూ కెన్ గో అవుట్ అండ్ యూ డు నాట్ హ్యావ్ టు డ్రైవ్ ఇన్ ద సిటీ ట్రాఫిక్. అండ్ ఎంప్లాయీ ట్రాన్స్పోర్టేషన్ సొల్యూషన్ ఎలా పనిచేస్తుందంటే, ఇప్పుడు ఒక కంపెనీకి లెట్స్ సే దర్ అబౌట్ 300-400 ఎంప్లాయీస్ అండ్ ఆ ఎంప్లాయీస్కి క్యాబ్ పికప్ అండ్ డ్రాప్ సర్వీస్ వస్తుంది. సో ఆ పికప్ అండ్ డ్రాప్ సర్వీస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్ఎఫిషియంట్ ఉంటుంది. అంటే యాక్చువల్లీ యాక్టివిటీ ఏం జరుగుతుంది, ఎంప్లాయీ ఎప్పుడు వస్తున్నాడు, క్యాబ్ లేట్ వెళ్ళిందా, టైంకి వచ్చిందా, యూ డోంట్ నో అబౌట్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దాట్. సో వీఆర్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ ఎ లొకేషన్ బేస్డ్ సర్వీస్ అలాంగ్ విత్ ఆర్టిఫిషియల్ ఇంటెలిజెన్స్, సో దట్ the entire activity of cab pickup and drop is organized in a beautiful dashboard. Ante admins ki gaani employees ki gaani, let's say female employees unnaru and their parents wants to know that the female employees are safe, so they can get a tracking link where they know that their daughter or their wife is being transported to the company safely. అండ్ ఆల్సో మా మెయిన్ ఫోకస్ ఏంటంటే ఎంప్లాయీ సేఫ్టీ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఎఫిషియన్సీ ఫర్ కంపెనీస్. కార్పొరేట్ కంపెనీస్కి ఇట్స్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ కాస్ట్ ట్రాన్స్పోర్టేషన్, సో వీఆర్ ట్రయింగ్ టు బ్రింగ్ డౌన్ ద కాస్ట్ అలాంగ్ విత్ ఎఫిషియన్సీ అండ్ ఆల్సో ప్రొవైడ్ సేఫ్టీ అండ్ సెక్యూరిటీ ఫర్ ఎంప్లాయీస్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఎంప్లాయీస్ ఫీల్ వెరీ కంఫర్టబుల్ దట్ దే ఆర్ గెటింగ్ ఎ సర్వీస్ దట్ ఈస్ సో కన్వీనియంట్. సో పీస్ మేము ఒక 1 ఇయర్ డ్రై రన్ చేసామండి 2016 నుంచి 2017 వరకు. ఇట్ వాజ్ మోర్ ఆఫ్ R&D, ట్రయింగ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ద మార్కెట్ అండ్ దెన్ ట్రయింగ్ టు గెట్ అ ఫ్యూ కస్టమర్స్ ఆన్ బోర్డ్ అండ్ ట్రయింగ్ అవుట్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ థింగ్స్. బట్ అఫీషియల్లీ కిక్ ఆఫ్ అయింది ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ 2017 అక్టోబర్. సిన్స్ దెన్ వీ వర్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ గ్రోయింగ్ వెరీ ర్యాపిడ్లీ అండ్ దెన్ వీ గాట్ అన్ ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ ఏ US బేస్డ్ గ్రూప్ అండ్ దే హ్యావ్ ఇంక్యుబేటెడ్ అస్ దేర్ ఇన్ దర్ ఓన్ స్పేస్. మా ఆఫీస్ రైట్ ఆపోజిట్ గూగుల్లో ఉంటుంది, కొండాపూర్ గూగుల్ ఆపోజిట్లో ఉంటుంది. అండ్ వీ ఆర్ డూయింగ్ ఎ టర్న్ ఓవర్ ఆఫ్ అబౌట్ 2.4 crores నౌ అండ్ రైట్ నౌ వీఆర్ ఎట్ దిస్ ఈవెంట్ టు రేస్ సమ్ మనీ అండ్ వీఆర్ లుకింగ్ ఎట్ అబౌట్ 2 to 5 crores ఆఫ్ ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ ఫర్ ఆర్ స్కేల్ అప్ ఆపరేషన్స్. మా మెయిన్ కస్టమర్స్ డ్రైవర్ ఆన్ డిమాండ్ బిజినెస్, అంటే డ్రైవర్స్ కార్స్ కావాల్సిన బిజినెస్కి ఇట్స్ మోర్ ఆఫ్ సీనియర్ పీపుల్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఉమెన్. సో 60% ఆఫ్ ది టార్గెట్ మార్కెట్ వుడ్ బి దెమ్. సో మా స్ట్రాటజీ ఏంటంటే వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ వేర్ ద కస్టమర్స్ వుడ్ నీడ్ డ్రైవర్స్. లెట్స్ ఏ టౌన్షిప్స్ ఉంటాయి, కమ్యూనిటీస్ ఉంటాయి, అపార్ట్మెంట్స్ ఉంటాయి. సో వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ దేర్ అండ్ ప్రమోటింగ్ అస్ ఇన్ దేర్ ఓన్ టౌన్షిప్ ఆర్ అపార్ట్మెంట్ ఫర్ ఎ కపుల్ ఆఫ్ డేస్ అండ్ లెటింగ్ పీపుల్ నో దట్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ సర్వీస్ కాల్డ్ విసిల్ డ్రైవ్ అండ్ దే కెన్ బుక్ ఎ డ్రైవర్ ఫ్రమ్ దేర్ అండ్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ యాక్చువల్లీ రెస్పాండింగ్ పాజిటివ్లీ బికాస్ ఇట్స్ అ వెరీ నెసెసరీ థింగ్ దట్ యూ నీడ్ అ డ్రైవర్ ఇన్ హైదరాబాద్ సిటీ ట్రాఫిక్. లెట్స్ ఏ ఇప్పుడు నేను ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇఫ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ టు గో టు కుక్కట్పల్లి the traffic is so heavy that I can't even drive and then women senior citizens ki gaani they cannot really drive in this traffic and then outstation trip kellalana they want to focus on what's there ante vaalla kids tho gaani aadkodamo lekapothe they want to focus on what they want to do not driving right. So it's kind of helpful for them. The challenges that we are facing is the market promotion in terms of how to scale up our marketing because we are right now on a specific budget. So right now mem funds kosam chustunnamo so that we can scale up our marketing and the sales so that we can reach a lot more people than what we are doing right now. And we are already doing about 125 rides a day driver on demand lo and we are transporting anything close to 1,000 employees a day in our own cabs. So we have our own cabs and also we have an integrated software employee transportation ki. So that's how it's going right now.
So many challenges. First thing is the marketing is a very big challenge which a startup entrepreneur faces. But you know, it again depends on how you market yourself and how you make your product. The quality all you maintain and how you counsel your customers mainly. See, selling should not be your ultimate goal. The only thing is first you understand the customer needs. You need to talk to the customer, counsel the customers. Don't exactly focus on selling your product. Just try to listen to the customer, what exactly is his requirement. Then try to counsel him what exactly he's looking for. Then sell your product. This is what is the concept what we have been following since a long time. That is really making us helpful to promote our products because people are really happy that we are not just asking them to buy our products. We are just telling them, see, this is what is happening exactly and this is what is going to happen when you use some chemicals on your skin and hair. Then we are also suggesting them to take good diet along with the beauty products what we are selling them because beauty products are the supplements. But a good diet also matters when we talk about the beauty. So the diet as the and the beauty goes simultaneously. So that's the reason I always tell my customers or whoever it is, like, to focus on that diet as well as on the beauty products as well, which are the additional supplements, you can say. So this is how, like, we have been creating awareness about our brand. My ultimate goal is to see my company on the Fortune 500 companies.
So revenues are good, and each store is able to sell on an average 3 lakhs worth of products in a month. So major challenge vachesi, so as the people evaraithe store run chestunaro, so vallu localize ay untaru, so vallu kuda rural people. So meer annattu they don't know much about technology, they don't know much about internet and all. సో మేము ఏం చేస్తున్నామంటే వాళ్ళని ఫస్ట్ ఎడ్యుకేట్ చేస్తున్నాం. సో వాళ్ళు ఒక ప్రోడక్ట్ని అమ్మగలగాలి అంటే వాళ్ళకి చాలా తెలిసి ఉండాలి. సో ఆర్ ఛాలెంజెస్ బేసికలీ లైస్ దేర్ వేర్ ఇన్ ట్రైనింగ్ ద పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ సెటింగ్ అప్ స్టోర్స్. సో దానికోసం చాలా ఇన్నోవేటివ్ మెథడ్స్తో వర్క్ చేస్తున్నాము అండ్ ఐమ్ షూర్ దట్ విల్ ఫిగర్ అవుట్ వెరీ గుడ్ వేస్ టు ట్రైన్ దీస్ పీపుల్.
ఈ మేము వర్క్ చేస్తున్న కంపెనీ నేమ్ ఈల్యాబ్. ఈల్యాబ్ అంటే ఆంటర్ప్రినర్షిప్. మై నేమ్ ఇస్ శరత్. ఐఎమ్ అడ్వర్టైజింగ్ క్రియేటర్, కాంటెంట్ క్రియేటర్ దేర్. సో ఇక్కడ మామూలుగా ఈ రోజుల్లో ఉద్యోగాలు దొరకడమే కష్టం. అట్లాంటిది ఇప్పుడు ఇండియాలో మెయిన్ ప్రాబ్లం అన్ఎంప్లాయ్మెంటే. అట్లాంటి జాబ్ క్రియేట్ చేసే వాళ్ళని క్రియేట్ చేయడం మా కంపెనీ ఉద్దేశం. 2025 వరకు 1 మిలియన్ జాబ్ ఆంటర్ప్రినర్స్ని తయారు చేయడం మా లక్ష్యం. దానికి ఈ ప్లాట్ఫామ్ చాలా బెస్ట్ ప్లాట్ఫామ్. మేము ఇన్రోల్ చాలా ఈవెంట్స్ వెళ్ళినాం, అదంతా ఒక ఎత్తు అయితే ఈ ఒక్కటి ఒక ఎత్తు. దిస్ ఇస్ అ వెరీ వండర్ఫుల్ ఆపర్చునిటీ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ ఆఫ్ అస్. దాట్స్ వెరీ ఆసమ్.
హాయ్, ఐఎమ్ సంతోష్ తోట. ఐఎమ్ ఐఐటి గౌహతి అల్యుమిని యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ ఐఎమ్ ఫౌండర్ అండ్ సిఇఓ ఆఫ్ ద కంపెనీ కాల్డ్ స్మార్ట్ సోషల్. సో వీ ఆర్ ఇన్ టు వీ డెవలప్డ్ అన్ ఏఐ డ్రివెన్ సోషల్ మీడియా మార్కెటింగ్ ఆటోమేషన్ టూల్. సో ఎస్పెషలీ టు హెల్ప్ స్మాల్ అండ్ మీడియం బిజినెసెస్ టు గ్రో దెమ్ ఆర్గానికలీ ఇన్ సోషల్ మీడియా. సో వీ బీన్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ టు అనౌన్స్ దాట్ వీఆర్ యూనో వన్ ఆఫ్ ద 10 స్టార్ట్అప్ దట్ ఇస్ బీన్ సెలెక్టెడ్ టుడే ఫర్ దిస్ యూనో వండర్ఫుల్ ఈవెంట్, ఎస్ఎంసి ఈవెంట్. అండ్ so far it's so good. I mean, I came a little late, but actually the key highlight of the event is like the note from you know Mohan Reddy from CN. It was wonderful, you know, journey that he's been through throughout his company, you know, starting from zero to now almost like, you know, 7,000 crores of company. It's been a wonderful story to hear from him. And then we've been also participating in a couple of one-on-one sessions with mentors and investors. It's been wonderful so far, the experience, and looking forward to the evening event, which is which will be the live on-stage pitching, the 10 startups that we'll be pitching, and we are one of them, and looking forward to that event.
My name is Guda Venkatesh. I'm a serial entrepreneur. I'm an IITK alumni, computer science. And I went for the US for my PhD, and then after working in Bell Labs for a while, I started doing startups and never looked back. So after doing a couple of startups, now I do mentoring of startups both in the US and in India. I like the SMC platform because it's for the first time it's entrepreneurs who are experienced helping other entrepreneurs, right? And that's surely needed because you can't depend on the investors to do that. You can't depend on necessarily peers to do that, but experienced people who can come, and that's what attracted me here, to come and say, okay, so here are the entrepreneurs. It brings them into a thing. I have experience in these. I can help you. It's a way of giving back to the ecosystem, right? What we got, I had my mentors and I'm very grateful to them. I want to do the same thing for the others, right? And I've talked to a lot of the entrepreneurs who are here. I mean, it's fantastic. The passion is there. The idea is there. It's just the experience, a little bit of the experience that's lacking. And if we can provide that, right, that's what's going to make the difference between, you know, just being one startup or something that's going to become a big success.
So what is your personal advice to budding entrepreneurs? What is your personal advice?
Get a thick skin, because you're going to hear a lot of bad things from investors who are going to say it's not going to work, everybody's going to... So listen to them, but get a thick skin. Don't get discouraged by somebody saying you suck. I mean, that's not good. Second, persevere. Because there'll be lots of ups and downs. It's never a smooth ride. So if you give up because some competition came up and said, oh, they're doing better now, you got to beat them. So just persevere throughout the thing and get some really good mentors who are experienced to help you because they really need it.
చాలా చాలా బాగుంది. ఎందుకంటే ఇంతకు ముందర 5 ఏళ్ల క్రితం 6 ఏళ్ల క్రితం 10 ఏళ్ల క్రితం ఇప్పుడు మీరు మీ ఇంటికి వెళ్ళి నేను ఇప్పుడు ఈ ఉద్యోగం మానేసి నేను కంపెనీ పెడతాను అని అంటే పిచ్చోడిని చూసినట్టు చూసేవాడు. ఇప్పుడు ఒక అవసరం ఇది లేదు. ఇప్పుడు నువ్వు చేస్తా అంటే అరే చెయ్యి చెయ్యి 2 ఏళ్ళు చెయ్యి, ఏం పర్వాలేదు, ఉద్యోగం ఉన్నా లేకపోయినా చెయ్యి, ఒకళ్ళు వస్తే వచ్చింది, రాకపోతే మేము తర్వాత సపోర్ట్ చేయొచ్చు, తర్వాత ఉద్యోగం చేయొచ్చు అనేది ఒకటి. ఒక కల్చర్ పేరెంట్స్ దగ్గర కానీ ఫ్రెండ్స్ దగ్గర కానీ అందరి చోట్ల కానీ ఆ రిస్క్ తీసుకోమనే కల్చర్ ఒకటి బాగా చేంజ్ అయింది. దానివల్ల బాగా పిల్లలు, స్టూడెంట్స్ కానీ ఎంప్లాయీస్ కానీ ఎవరైనా సరే ఐడియా ఉన్నవాళ్ళు దే ఆర్ విల్లింగ్ టు స్టార్ట్. అంటే మొదలు పెట్టడానికి వాళ్ళకేమీ అంటే వెనకాల వెనక్కి లాగేవాళ్ళు ఎవరు లేరు. అలా కాకుండా ఈకోసిస్టంలో కూడా మీకు చాలా వరకు ఫండింగ్ కానీ ఇది కానీ చాలా ఈజీగా దొరుకుతుంది. గవర్నమెంట్ ఎంత సపోర్ట్ ఇస్తుందంటే మాకు మా సిస్టంలో ఇప్పుడు మేము 82 కంపెనీలు ఐఐటీలో ఉన్నాయి. ఫ్యాకల్టీ కింద మేము ఐఐటీలో కంపెనీలు స్టార్ట్ చేసి రన్ చేయొచ్చు వితౌట్ లీవింగ్ ద జాబ్. మా పిల్లలు స్టార్ట్ చేసి రన్ చేయొచ్చు, ఒక ఏడాది లీవ్ తీసుకున్న, 6 నెలలు లీవ్ తీసుకున్న, అక్కడ వాళ్ళు కూడా కంపెనీలు రన్ చేయొచ్చు. బయట వాళ్ళు వచ్చి మా దగ్గర కంపెనీలు రన్ చేయొచ్చు. గవర్నమెంట్ దగ్గర సీడ్ ఫండింగ్ కింద 25 లక్షలు 50 లక్షలు అయితే అసలు వాళ్ళు ఎవరైనా వచ్చి కూర్చుని చేస్తాము అంటే చాలు, వాళ్ళకి ఇచ్చే అవకాశాలు చాలా ఇదిగా ఉన్నాయి. సో ఇప్పుడు ఈకోసిస్టమ్ ఈ రోజున ఏదైతే మనం చూస్తున్నామో ఇట్స్ రియలీ 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 వైబ్రెంట్. 10,000 స్టార్టప్ కంపెనీస్ ఇప్పుడు ఏడాదికి 50% 50% తరపున పెరుగుతున్నాయి. 100 ఇంక్యుబేటర్లు హబ్బులు 100 150 ఇంక్యుబేటర్స్ ఉన్నాయి మన దగ్గర. అది కాకుండా బయట ప్రైవేట్ ఇంకా చాలా ఉన్నాయి. ఎవరైనా సరే ఈరోజు ఎవరైనా మొదలెడితే పిల్లలు కానీ పెద్దవాళ్ళు కానీ ఇది ఒక పెద్ద ఇదైపోయింది. అంటే ఒక 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 రకంగా చూడాలంటే ఒక ఫినామినాన్ కింద తయారైంది అనమాట ఈ స్టార్టప్ ఇదనేది ఇండియాలో. అంటే 10 ఏళ్ల క్రితం అమెరికాలో ఎలా అయితే ఉందో ఈ రోజున మనకి అలాగుంది ఇండియాలో. దాట్స్ హౌ ఇట్ ఈస్. సక్సెస్ రేట్ నార్మల్లీ స్టార్టప్లో బయట ఏం చెప్తారు మనకి, నార్మల్గా థియరటికల్గా చెప్పాలి అంటే 5% ఉంటుంది 10% ఉంటుంది అని చెప్తారు. కానీ అది యాక్యురేట్ కాదు. ఎందుకంటే ఈకోసిస్టమ్ ఏదైతే సపోర్ట్ సిస్టమ్ ఏదైతే అది బాగా ఉన్నప్పుడు ఆల్మోస్ట్ 50-60% మనకి సక్సెస్ రేట్ వస్తుంది. అంటే దానిలో రెండు రకాల సక్సెస్ ఉంటుంది. ఒకటేమో మీరు ఒక లైఫ్ స్టైల్ కంపెనీ కింద అంటే నెలకింత వస్తుంది హాయిగా అలా గ్రో అవుతో 10 ఏళ్ళు వెళ్ళిపోతుంది కంపెనీ అనేది ఒక రకమైన సక్సెస్. ఇంకోటి ఏంటంటే ఫినామినల్ సక్సెస్, అంటే అసలు ప్రపంచంలోనే అదొక తార్కాణం కింద నిలబడే లాంటి కంపెనీలు, ఆ సక్సెస్ వేరు. సో ఈ మొత్తం ఈకోసిస్టమ్ తీసుకుంటే ఆ ఏదైతే ఫినామినల్గా ప్రపంచానికే మనం కంట్రిబ్యూట్ చేస్తున్నాము అనే ఏ సక్సెస్ అయితే ఉందో అది మీకు 5% కంటే రాదండి. మొత్తం పెట్టిన దాంట్లో 5% వస్తే చాలా గొప్ప మనకి. అంటే ఒక గూగుల్ వచ్చిందంటే మనకు చాలా గ్రేట్ అన్నమాట. ఇప్పుడు సైంట్ ల్యాండ్ కంపెనీ ఉంది, వాళ్ళు ఈ రోజున అంతా 7,000 కోట్లు 1,200 కోట్లు చేతిలో ఉన్నాయి. అంటే ఇట్ టుక్ హిమ్ టు బిల్డ్ సో మెనీ, ఇట్స్ ఎ గ్లోబల్ కంపెనీ. అలాంటి 5% వస్తాయి. మిగతా అన్నిటి మోస్ట్లీ రన్నింగ్ రన్ అవుతాయి. ఒక 10 ఏళ్ళు 20 ఏళ్ళు ఇంతలో కాంపిటీషన్ వస్తుంది, టెక్నాలజీ మారుతుంది, మళ్ళీ చేంజ్ అవుతుంది. బట్ ఓవరాల్గా చూసుకుంటే 60-70% ఈజీగా మన దగ్గర సక్సెస్ రేట్ ఉంటుంది. అది ఏమీ లిటరేచర్ ప్రకారం చూసి 10% వస్తుంది 1% వస్తుంది అనేది కరెక్ట్ కాదు. మీరు ఎక్కడికి వెళ్ళిన ఈ వ్యాలీ ఆఫ్ డెత్ అని చూపిస్తాడు. స్టార్టప్ అవుతుంది కొంతసేపు అయ్యంగానే దిస్ ఇస్ ద వ్యాలీ ఆఫ్ డెత్, అంతే లోయ ఉంటుంది. ఆ లోయలోకి అందరూ వెళ్ళిపోతారు, ఇంకెవరు పైకి రారు, ఒకళ్ళో ఇద్దరు బయటకు వస్తారు. కానీ అది నిజం కాదు. ఇండియాలో అయితే ఇప్పుడు ప్రస్తుతానికి ఉన్న సిట్యువేషన్లో అది నిజం కాదు. అలాగుండదండి, సెక్టర్ వైజ్ మనం స్టార్టప్లో సెక్టర్ వైజ్ అసలు మనం ఆలోచించలేము. అంటే ఇప్పుడు కరెంట్గా మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద మొత్తం అంతా కూడా ఇప్పుడు మనకి మెషిన్ లెర్నింగ్ ఐటీ ఐఓటీ సిస్టమ్స్లోకి వెళ్తుంది టెక్నాలజీ. అంటే జనాల అవసరాలు దాని ఆ విధంగా ఉన్నాయి ఈ రోజున. ఆ అవసరం ప్రకారం ప్రతి ఒళ్ళు అటేవైపు మొగ్గు చూపుతారు. టెక్నాలజీ ఇంజనీరింగ్ సైడ్ చూపుతున్నారు, కానీ అది చూసినప్పుడు కానీ అందరూ అటువైపు వెళ్ళడానికి ట్రై చేస్తారు. అందుకని మీకు ఎక్కువ అటువైపు కనబడుతుంది. కానీ దానిలో సర్వైవల్ రేట్ కూడా తగ్గిపోతుంది, ఎందుకంటే ఎక్కువ మంది వచ్చేసారు కదా. సో దట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్వేస్ దేర్. అది మనిషి స్టార్టప్ వాళ్ళ ఇన్హరెంట్ ఏదైతే స్ట్రెంగ్త్ ఏదైతే ఉందో ఎంటర్ప్రెనర్ది, దేనివల్ల అది ఉపయోగించడం వలన వాళ్ళకి ఎక్కడైతే వేరే వాళ్ళు కాంపిటీషన్ అందుకోలేరు అది అదే డిఫరెన్స్. సో దాని మీదే ఒక ఎంటర్ప్రెనర్ ప్లే చేయాలి. ఇప్పుడు నువ్వు ఫ్లిప్కార్ట్ వాళ్ళు పెట్టారు, నేను కూడా ఇంకో ఫ్లిప్కార్ట్ పెడతానంటే కుదరదు, ఇట్ వోంట్ వర్క్ ఫర్ హిమ్. తను ఏం చేస్తున్నాడు టేబుల్ దగ్గరికి, అది ఎలా వేరే వాళ్ళు తొందరగా ఎలా ఫాలో చేయకుండా ఉండగలరు, దానివల్ల ఆయన అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఎంత ఉంది, దాని మీద బిజినెస్ బిల్డ్ అవుతుంది. సో దట్ వే డొమైన్ అనేది ఈ స్పెసిఫిక్ టు పీపుల్. ఫ్యాషన్ కింద అందరం వెళ్ళిపోతాం. ఇప్పుడు ఒక ఈ కామర్స్ రాగానే 50 ఈ కామర్స్ సైట్లు వచ్చింది, అన్నీ నిలబడలేదు కదా. ఇప్పుడు 4 ఏళ్ళ వాల్యుయేషన్లు పడిపోయింది, అదైతే ఉంటుంది. దానివల్ల ఉపయోగం లేదు. కాకపోతే మోస్ట్లీ ఇప్పుడు మెషిన్ లెర్నింగ్, ఇంటర్నెట్ ఆఫ్ టెక్నాలజీస్ ఈ డొమైన్లోనే మెయిన్లీ ఇన్ ఆటోమేషన్లోకే వెళ్తుంది ఇప్పుడు. దానిలో అన్ని ఇంజనీరింగ్ సైన్సెస్ వస్తాయి మీకు. మెటీరియల్స్ దగ్గర నుంచి, మెకానికల్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ దగ్గర నుంచి, ఐటీ దగ్గర నుంచి, సిస్టమ్స్ దగ్గర నుంచి, ఇవన్నీ కూడా కలిపి రావాలి అది ముందరికి వెళ్ళాలి అంటే. ఒక డొమైన్ అనేది లేదు, దానికి ఉన్న యాన్సిలరీ ఇండస్ట్రీస్ అన్ని డొమైన్స్ నుంచి ఉన్నాయి. బడ్డింగ్ ఎంటర్ప్రెనర్స్కి నేను చెప్పేది ఏంటంటే, ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ యంగ్, ఇప్పుడే పాస్ అవుతున్నారు లేకపోతే పాస్ అయ్యి 4 ఏళ్ళు అయింది, ఒక 2 ఏళ్ళు ఇందులో పెట్టి మళ్ళీ రేపొద్దున్న 50 ఏళ్ళు వచ్చాక వెనక్కి తిరిగి ఆలోచించి అనుకోకూడదు అయ్యో ఆ రోజు నేను చేసి ఉండాల్సిందే అని అనుకోకుండా ఆ రిస్క్ తీసుకోమని నేను చెప్తానండి. ఆ రిస్క్ వాళ్ళు చేస్తే అట్లీస్ట్ సక్సెస్ అయినా అవ్వకపోయినా ఆ లెర్నింగ్స్ ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో అవి వాళ్ళ జీవితంలో ఉపయోగపడతాయి. ఒకటి సక్సెస్ అయితే మరీ మంచిది, సక్సెస్ కాకపోయినా సరే రేపొద్దున ఆ రిగ్రెట్ అయితే ఉండదు, అయ్యో నేను చేయలేదు, నేను ఆ రోజు చేసి ఉండే, అరే ఇంజుడు నేను ఆ ఐడియానే తీసుకుని ఎంత పెద్దోడు అయ్యాడు అనే ఇది లేకుండా ఉంటుంది. అందుకని నేను అంటాను దే షుడ్ ట్రై. ఇది వెన్ యు ఆర్ యంగ్ యూ హ్యావ్ సో మచ్ ఎనర్జీ దట్ యూ షుడ్ బి ఏబుల్ టు పుట్ ద ఎఫర్ట్ అండ్ ట్రై.
Yeah, I am Pradeep Bhargav, President of Alumni Association IIT Kanpur. We started the Startup Master class around 4 years back with an idea of engaging our students who have started as alums in the world. And what we realized was this was one of the best methods to engage the startups and also help them interact with the senior entrepreneurs who were also from the institute. And that is how we began. So in the last 4 years, it grew from 70 people event to almost 1300 people event in IIT Kanpur in the last month. And today here we will have around 600 people attending this.
So how's the response?
Response has been very great. So what has happened is as people first come, they realize the type of speakers that we have, the type of interaction that is possible, and the type of involvement that we have both with the local people and also different parts of the ecosystem. For example, people in the incubation side or the accelerator or the mentor or the investor. So whole idea is that startups must integrate with them. They should be able to know them. In addition to that, startups must interact with each other. Because all the startups, when they have to work with less amount of cash and give faster results. If you have to do both, then you should know people. You pick up a phone and say, okay, I want this, and a person gets a response in 5 minutes. That is very different from a corporate where you may go through a process or have to pay a substantial amount of money to get the same service.
So what are the main challenges facing entrepreneurs in India?
So some of the challenges entrepreneurs look at is what to do really, what to start. So first they will look at an idea itself, whether it is saleable or scalable. Second, then they no sooner they start, they look at who should be the founders and getting the right founders. And that is where sometimes we straight away get a friend whom I know in college or whom I have met sometime in my work. But that may not necessarily be always the best combination of startup founders. The third thing they would look at, now if I have a product and people, then how do I take it forward to the market? As they are grappling with that, the question then comes is, if I need money, then who will help me? So more often than not, they will start with some idea of a money which runs short. So without completing the first milestone, they would be looking for funds which are not available. So these are the initial challenges with the startup space.
So how did you help them grow or come out from your side?
From our side, when startups come, firstly we see that whether they are covering these basic questions right. So some of the questions are, what are you really addressing? To whom you are addressing? What is your product and how would you price it? Is there a buyer for such a product? What is the existing competition? If I have to scale, how large you can scale? Because if I go up to, for example, if I start with a business of 10 lakhs and it will only go up to 1 crore, not many investors may be interested in that. So investors would be interested in something which could go really large. At the same time, even at a smaller level, it should start showing results that we can say, yes, this is a business investor would put in money. So what we do is we get them to interact with other entrepreneurs. We have in this session also one-on-one where a startup can choose any of the speaker, any of the mentor or the investor and get 5 to 10 minutes during the event. But some can also pursue later on. Within our further help support, we have workshops which make sure that they cover these basic points so that they would less likely to fail and be more likely to succeed. And these are small steps that we are taking. So as I said, that we have grown in the last 4 years. So we would have more than 1,000 startups which have participated in this. More than 6,000 people attended Startup Master class at different parts. And people like to come again, which means it's definitely helping them. So there are people who have got funded, there are people who got business, there are people who got networked, and the people who are able to scale up when they have come here.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Rishi. I run a company called Trimer Software. We are based and headquartered in Hyderabad, and we have presence globally. We have companies in Singapore, Germany, and Netherlands. and we have a team of about 150 plus people. We work on outsourced software product development. So we basically become partners for startups and big companies, and we understand their business problems and we design custom solutions around those problems, and we execute it end to end. So basically the companies can focus on the business side and we can take care from the requirements, then design, development, testing, deployment in the production also. Recently we have started, you know, apart from the regular web and mobile applications also, we have started migrating into newer areas like blockchain and, you know, machine learning, artificial intelligence, many other interesting verticals.
So what is your company position? Is it good track or you faced any problems?
No, not at all. I think we are doing pretty good. We are based in Hyderabad. We have very good team. We are expanding globally nowadays. So this year we are anticipating very nice growth. Last couple of years, earlier we were part of CIE in IIIT, so we were part of that incubator. Last 2 years, we are part in Couple Towers, and we are expanding globally. So I think the times are good. I think we are doing reasonably okay.
So in initial stages,
you face any problems or any tough challenges? Definitely. I mean, initially when we were starting out, there were many, many challenges. We were an unknown company. You know, hiring was a big, big problem. We used to go out and talk to many clients to give us the work. But then because you are a new startup, no one gives you work at that point of time. But you know, the Hyderabad ecosystem has been very, very helping. The IIT ecosystem has been very helping. So I'm from a 2004 batch of IIT Kanpur. Lot of alumni, lot of, you know, friends and families and people had a lot of good connects. So I got a lot of initial work and traction from there. And then slowly we built on top of it, right? And you know, about 5 years down the line now, we have very, very big clients. So, you know, Patanjali, Baba Ramdev, we are building their entire e-commerce platform at this point of time, right? We are working with delivery, doing supply chain solutions for them. We are working with various banks. We are working in Singapore with Systic, which is one of the entertainment largest company, which is equivalent of Book My Show, if you know about them, so something like that. So yeah, I mean, you have to start somewhere at a smaller project, lower scale level, but slowly graduate from there. Thank you.